Okay, good morning. So for today's discussion, we will discuss about prepared poultry and game dishes. But before we go deeper with our discussion, please bear with me kung may mga naririnig kayo mga tricycles, mga motor. Due to I am malapit lang ako sa kalsada, kaya please listen carefully. Okay, so under this discussion, four elements. If you have already browsed your module na binigay ko sa GCR natin, we have four elements under this topic. First one, we have identify and select poultry game meats. Second, prepare poultry and game meats. Third, cook, hold, and present. And the last one is store poultry and game products. Each element have subtopics. Kaya medyo madugo, medyo lang naman, medyo madugo yung magiging topics natin, discussion natin due to napakahaba or malawak yung coverage niya. So, let's start with the first element. The first element that is identify and select poultry and game meats. So, we have six subtopics. And hopefully, matapos natin lahat-lahat. So the first subtopic is identify varieties of poultry and game, identify commercial establishment cuts and specification. The third one is identify and select suppliers for purchasing of products. The fourth one, minimize wastage through freshness and correct purchasing. Fifth, identify cost through yield testing. And the sixth one is to ensure correct conditions are maintained for freshness and quality. Siguro at some part, nalilito kayo sa module na binigay ko. It is because that module that was given to you guys was from TESDA. Yan yung ginagamit talaga nila in NC2, Cookery NC2. Okay, kaya may mga tawag dito mga definition of terms, merong mga work projects na nakalagay dyan, and most especially iba yung nasa book, yung mga ordinary books sa school natin sa module na binibigay ko. Okay, so let's start with the first subtopic, and that is to identify varieties of poultry and game. So when we hear the word poultry, ang laging pumapasok sa isip natin is chicken, right? Chicken, manok, anakad pie. Kasi parang wala na tayong ibang idea about poultry aside from chicken. But don't you know that there are varieties of poultry, not just the usual chicken na inuulam natin or not just the usual chicken na alam natin. Okay, let's go deeper with the discussion. So when you say poultry, these are domesticated birds kept by humans for their eggs, meats, and even feathers. Yes, hindi lang naman yung mga meats and eggs ang kinukonsume natin. For some designers or yung mga gumagawa ng mga damit, they use those feathers to decorate or use as a material for something na kine-create nila. Aside from that, poultry can be classified as domestic birds or fowl grown for human consumption. When we say domestic or domesticated, these are kung sa Tagalog ay inaalagaan natin. Hindi kinakatakutan yung mga pagka or yung mga hayop na ito. Hindi siya kinakatakutan. In the other words pa, aside from inaalagaan, is that it is more of consumption. Ginagamit natin ito for consumption. Aside from these two definitions of poultry, we also have game birds. Game birds are also classified as poultry, as most are now farmed for human consumption. Most game birds would be classified as specialty poultry. Baka nako-confuse kayo sa word na game. Everything na ginagamit ko na term dito is not for the literal meaning. When we say game, these are more of yung mga meats natin under poultry. So, we will discuss later on kung ano ba yung mga game birds, kung ano ba yung mga game myths na yan. Okay, next. So, we have here different types of poultry. Actually, these are some types of poultry lang na linagay ko. Sa module ninyo, mas marami pa doon. Of course, the usual poultry na alam natin, that is chicken. Aside from chicken, we also have duck. We have these wild ducks and the ordinary duck. We also have quail. Saan ba nanggagaling yung itlog pugo na sinasabi natin? That is from quail. Alam ba ninyo kung ano yung itsura ng quail? I will show you later on. We have also poussin. Poussin, these are baby chicken. They are killed nung bata pa. I mean, kinukonsume na, kinakain na yung mga chicken, yung mga baby chicken. Tekunada nga, pilk kunada. Those are poussin. Next, we have this squab or what we call the pigeon. Squab, these are the small version or immature pigeon. Yung mas maliit lang, just like the pusin. Yung pusin kasi, piyok pa lang isunakit kang kaninin. Did you squab mat, babasit pa lang a pigeon, ket kang kanindan. So, that's the, these are the different types of poultry. When you say poultry, we have this what we call the specialty poultry and the game birds, which is for some luxury or expensive restaurants, ino-offer talaga nila ito. But in Ilocos Norte, I think, hindi, ordinary chicken lang, nagpo-focus lang sila sa chicken. Just like yung mga restaurants natin, nag-ooperate pa ba ang Macy's Diner? We have also Jerry's Grill, but I think hindi sila nag-o-offer ng mga specialty poultry and game birds, just chicken. Okay? When we say specialty poultry, these are birds that might be special for occasion or seasonal celebration. If you are watching, of course, you are watching movies, international movies, Hollywood movies, may mga occasions, special occasions na meron silang sinaserve or dinidisplay ng mga specialty poultry and game birds, yung mga malalaking poultry. Aside from this one, we also have game birds. These are primarily wild birds now domesticated and bred for the market but mainly used in restaurants. Just like what I have said, in Ilocos Norte, for those formal dining restaurants, nagpo-focus lang sila sa chicken. Wala silang ibang ino-offer aside from chicken as their poultry. Okay, but for some restaurants in other countries, yes, marami. Marami yung ino-offer nila na iba't ibang klase ng poultry. Okay, next slide. So, I have listed here different types of specialty poultry and game birds. Let's start with the specialty poultry. We have goose. I think you know this one kasi nakakakita na tayo ito dito sa atin. This one, this is a goose. We have also quail. Kaya dito lang siya yung nagbibigay or siya yung nangingitlog ng quail eggs na kinakain natin yung pugo. And we have also the wild duck. The picture that I have placed in our presentation, it's a Philippine duck. Wild duck lang siya. Hangat ay maipupupok, nandyan lang siya sa labas-labas. Another, we have also game birds. Ito, baka hindi kayo masyadong familiar with this game birds kasi nakikita siguro natin but we don't know that pwede pa siyang i-consume. We don't know na maari pala natin siyang kainin. First, we have the mutant bird, this one. When you say mutant bird, this is more of seabirds, yung mga lumilipad-lipad sa dagat. Pero sa atin, I think wala ano, pero for in the other country, yes, meron. We have also peasant, this one. Very colorful siya. And we have also the guinea fowl, this one. And gaya ng laging inuulit-ulit ko na sinasabi, game birds are not available here in Ilocos Norte, but may be available for some places within the Philippines. Okay, so since we've done discussing about poultry, and I know you already have the idea about poultry, kasi nga, kung nasumursurot kayo ka ni mama yon, ni lula yon, or ni tita yon nga pang gumatgatang, you know what is poultry. So, aside from this one, aside from poultry, in the title of our topic today is poultry and game. Baka yung idea ninyo ng game is paglalaro, ano, but no. We have different terms when we are referring to cookery. We have different terms when we are referring to foods. So when we say game or the game meats, these are domesticated birds kept by humans for their eggs, meats, and feathers. There are two classifications of game. We have the furred, yung mga na adada, tawag dito ha, adada buok-buok na, those are furred game. And we have also the feathered game, dito ada dot-dot na, the feathers na. In your module, merong mga naka-indicate doon na mga pictures of different classifications of game. We have the furred and the feathered. Alright, so we have these different types of game meats. We have crocodile, wild duck, snake, pig, other wild meats. So when we say game meats, this is more of wild animals na kinukonsume natin. But for some stores or restaurants, sa stores, especially sa mga groceries, wala silang ino-offer ng mga ganito. Especially sa Hyper, Save More, Pure Gold, wala. It is more of the poultry meats lang. And this type of game meats is usually served in a luxury restaurants, but here in Ilocos Norte, wala. Hindi sila nagsiserve ng ganito. Gaya ng sinabi ko, it is more of chicken. Okay, so since we are done with the first subtopic under this element, let's move on to the second subtopic, and that is identify commercial establishment cuts and specification. So on this subtopic, this is more of the different cuts na nakikita ninyo sa mga dry markets natin, because we have two kinds of markets. We have the wet market and the dry market. When we say wet market, tiendaan, and when we have dry market, it's on the groceries. Okay, kung sumasama kayo, kinamama ninyo, tita ninyo, or ate ninyo na bumibili or nagro-grocery, especially sa mga meat section, if you notice, guys, there are different cuts of meats, especially sa poultry. Meron tayong tinatawag na mga drumsticks, mga fillet, wings, legs, di ba? Nakikita ninyo yon. So, on this subtopic, we will go deeper, we will have a deeper discussion with the different cuts, okay? If you are purchasing, poultry can be purchased fresh, frozen, or any multitude or processed ways. Pero sabi ng mga nakakatanda, it is better na bumili ka kapag fresh yung mismong poultry. That is to ensure that the food that you will consume is safe. Wala siyang anumang mga contamination with other bacteria. Okay? And when you are purchasing, it is very important to look for the different quality or different characteristic that signifies that certain poultry or chicken is fresh. Ano ba yung mga dapat na tinitignan natin para masabi natin fresh yung mga binibili natin mga poultry? First one, it's the skin color. If you notice, share ko lang ulit, yesterday, nagpunta ako sa Hyper and I am about to purchase some chicken. And then suddenly I noticed that at some part or at some part of a certain chicken cut a brown and then a greenish tilangana. And that is no longer fresh. From the skin color pa lang, masasabi mo na na, ay matagal na to. Matagal nang stock to, matagal nang nakadisplay to. And that is an indication that you should not pick or buy or purchase that certain piece of chicken. Aside from the skin color, it's the odor. Jay, angot na. Malalaman mo naman eh, di ba? Kapag medyo hindi na maganda yung amoy, definitely hindi na quality and hindi na fresh yung poultry. And one characteristic that you should also know is that it should be feel, not slimy or sticky. You know what is a good quality or good characteristic of a fresh poultry is that hindi siya napigot, isuna hanga sticky and slimy. Parang wala lang, it's kapag hinawakan mo lang, it's rough. Walang didikit na kahit anumang liquid or sediments dito sa kamay mo kapag hinawakan mo. Next, no, bracing or bruises. Wala siyang mga tear, wala siyang mga kahit anumang mga sugat-sugat kumbaga. Another, we also need to consider this one. It should be no feathers, especially in markets. Kapag bumibili tayo ng mga chicken, dapat walang feather na. Kasi bago siya mapunta or bago siya ma-display doon sa pinagkukuhanan natin, dapat na-check na ng mga mismong nagtitinda kung fresh ba or quality ba yung chicken na binebenta nila. However, there are cases, most of the time, kung tinitignan ninyo, chinecheck ninyo yung mga binibili natin ng mga poultry in supermarkets, meron pang mga isa, dalawa, or tatlo, more than three feathers na nakikita. But that's okay as long as hindi ganun kadami yung feathers na nakikita natin. Nevertheless, kung sa bahay-bahay lang naman natin, okay lang naman yon. Pero kapag bumibili na tayo sa labas, you should check this one. Another, no broken limbs. Hindi po siya dapat na tukol-tukol isuna, especially on the part of the bones. Ano? There are cases na kapag hinawakan mo yung especially on the thigh part, di ba yung thigh part natin, it's bony isuna. There are bones or there is a bone inside that thigh part of a chicken. Kapag broken siya, especially the bone, hindi na siya pwede. Kasi mabalin nga during the delivery or during DJ panangyornos da amin dagsi ilako da ket haan nga napintasan. That is an indication also that that certain chicken or certain poultry is already contaminated. Okay. Aside from that one, breast bone should still be flexible. Especially yung breast, it's firm dapat. Hindi siya broken or hindi siya tawag dito. Hindi siya alisto lang matukol. It should be flexible. Is 'di ba yung breast bone ng chicken, it's not that hard. Pwede mo pa naman siyang i-move. And the last one, when buying your chicken, you should know that the fat and the carcass should be white in color. If you notice, there are parts of a certain poultry, especially chicken, na whitish ang mukha. As in, hindi siya clear, whitish ti kulay na. And those are the fats. And yes, it should be white, not dirty white, not yellow. It should be white. Okay, and aside from this characteristic na minamention ko na sinasabi ko, there are more characteristics that you should know kung bibili kayo ng mga chicken. Okay, so I suggest that if you are enrolled in cookery NC2, you should know this and you should have at least a time to search or browse the internet for more characteristics of good and fresh chicken or poultry. Okay? So, we have here different cuts of meats, especially yung mga chicken natin. We have halves. Ito lang yung hinati lang talaga sa gitna. And makikita ninyo, ito kung hindi ako nagkakamali, it's in Save More ata. Meron sila. Half lang. Pero pwede mo namang i-request yung whole chicken na i-half. Pwede naman yun. Another, it's fillet. Remember, sabi ko kanina, there are certain terms na ginagamit in foods that is, ang ibig sabihin ay hindi mismo yun yung ibig sabihin. It's not literally the definition of that certain word. Example, fillet. Fillet, when it comes to the cuts of meats, this refers to the breast. Meron tayong iba't ibang term. Especially when it comes to foods. When we say fillet, it's the breast. Another thing sa module ninyo, meron din siyang sinabi doon na term that is Maryland. When we say Maryland, this is the name of a menu, item, or dish that uses the leg as a whole. See? Baka numapang kayo agchenda or mapang kayo Jay Hyper, or say market, ay detaman fillet ko na na. There are cases na hindi alam ng mga vendors or ng mga mismong nagbabantay doon sa meat section kung ano yung fillet na sinasabi natin. However, for some stores naman, there are description na nakalagay doon mismo. Aside from fillet, it's wing, leg, buffet breast, drumstick, thigh, livers, spare ribs, and drumettes. These are the different cuts of meat. Pero yung pinaka-particular lang na cuts of meats natin, especially chicken, it's only 5. We have the wings, legs, the breast, drumsticks, and the thigh part. Yan lang yung pinaka 5 main cuts of meats natin. And the rest is linalagay na lang nila for other options. Okay?